Who on earth climbed out of a Taycan Turbo S and thought, that needs to be faster? Apparently someone did.
Welcome to Porsche's fastest accelerating car ever, the Taycan Turbo GT. And Porsche is so confident that its new 1,100 horsepower EV can break the street legal electric car lap record around Laguna Seca that it invited us along to watch lap time hero Lars Kern have a crack at it. The target? 1 minute 32 seconds set by a car from this neck of the Californian woods. Yep, a Tesla Model S Plaid. Place your bet. So, the Turbo GT annihilates the Tesla by almost 5 seconds, posting a 1 minute 27.87. And that was on his second attempt. Using a rather fetching purple example, Lars had already got the crowd going earlier in the day.
Okay, so I've collared the man at the moment. Lars, congratulations.
Thank you very much.
That's some stellar driving. I wanted to ask you, because EVs have a habit of making me feel a bit sick when I go fast in them. Tell me about the demands that this puts on your body.
I mean, at the end of the day, it's just, for me, it doesn't really matter where the power comes from, if it's like from electric motor or from combustion engine.
Okay.
You can always have more power, if you ask me. So we already spoke about that, even the car, the chassis, everything's so good, it could take even more power. But for me, yeah, not a problem. Pretty impressive car.
But you don't feel like, you know, when you drop down into the corkscrew or something, do you feel like your stomach turnover?
No.
Or you just...
No, because you're so tense. It's like, yeah, you're not moving an inch. So sure. You're like, just going to wrestle the car around.
Yeah.
But yeah, really cool.
And around here, when you've got a 90 second lap or a little bit less than that, it's pretty short. Tell me which corner is the critical one for most lap time? So the corkscrew?
No, the left-hander before corkscrew.
Oh, I see. That leads to that uphill.
Exactly. Over this little crest, and then it's this fast left-hander uphill because you have to get it right. Other than that, you miss the run towards corkscrew. That's, for me, that's the key corner.
Cool. And I noticed that lastly, like, we almost missed your lap time because you went out, did one out lap, and then the lap record was always the first flying lap. Yeah. Is that just because the tires don't last?
I mean, we figured out in the prep already that the difference between the first and the second lap, it's like a tenth or two. And now we're talking like really small margins, and this is already enough. But we did like 28. Look at the tires now. They look still brand new. So as soon as they cool down, you can use them again. It's just surface temperature. It's just really high because, I mean, 2.2 tons put a lot of energy into the tires.
And how many laps could you do on one charge, do you think?
On one charge, the charge is not really an issue. The problem is the battery temp and engine temp, or like electric engine temp. So we always did three flat out. This worked. And then the fourth would have been, you would have like lost power. But if you do cool downs in between, you're going to see when we do the taxi rides, it's, you can push a lot.
Right. Yeah, this is what I'm worried about. It's not just enough to watch it go by quickly. He's going to take me out for a passenger ride. Please be gentle.
No.
Before that, let's have a closer poke around the new Turbo GT, see what it's all about.
Right then, this is worth a few quid then, isn't it now? The official Laguna Seca lap record car, and this has got the Visac package. So obviously you've got your flicks down here. You've got the fixed rear wing at the back, but I wanted to show you in here because this has got, phew, it's unlocked. This has got a few extra little details. They've had to put this steel roll cage in to comply with the rules here at Laguna, and then that's added all this weight. So look, it's missing all this trim, all these trim pieces down there that have just desperately tried to take the plastic off to save some weight. And then check out the GT3 RS style steering wheel, the extra knobs and buttons and modes and the paddle shifters, so you can easily access the attack mode. That was what Lars, the driver, wanted. He wanted the attack mode, the boost at his fingertips for the ultimate lap time. Right, let's go and have a look at the normal one. Okay, now given this is the first time we've actually had a good look at an undisguised Taycan Turbo GT, here's your spotter's guide to see what's actually new. Starting with new front splitter, they've done a lot of aero work down the front actually, because you've got these curtains as well, 80 kilos of downforce at the front when you have the Visac package. This has also got forged wheels, and they've even updated the carbon ceramic brake package to save 2.2 kilograms. Carbon fiber fetishist, you get a carbon fiber B pillar, and actually we should have a look in here, because on a normal Turbo GT, you get back seats. I forgot to mention, on the Visac package, you don't. Now the Visac car is the one you've seen doing the lap, and that has the big fixed wing instead of the standard car's carbon fiber ducktail, and of course you get a Turbo GT badge. Now you might be thinking, well, that's not a lot of changes. There's a lot more underneath.
We all predicted the Turbo GT would be the first triple motor Taycan, following the template of the Tesla Model S Plaid and the Lucid Air Sapphire, but Porsche's engineers said they got the results they wanted, sticking with a dual motor layout. The front motor is a Turbo S carryover with new software, but the rear motor is lighter, more powerful, and connected to a revised gear ratio in the two-speed transmission. It develops up to 1100 brake horsepower in the 10-second attack mode, and will launch from 0 to 62 miles per hour in 2.3 seconds, or 2.2 with the 70 kilo lighter Visac package. And that's without any drag strip preparation or 1 foot rollout. Range is a claimed 344 miles, around 50 miles less than a Turbo S. And that really asks you the question, doesn't it? How much do you need a car that's quicker than a Turbo S? How much do you need to go from 0 to 125 miles an hour in 6.6 seconds instead of 7.7? If you're a speed merchant who'll only settle for the Turbo GT, a standard, you get Porsche's latest active suspension, which completely erases body roll, brake dive, or acceleration pitch, and it makes being a passenger totally relaxing, right?
It's just two guys just going for a leisurely drive.
That's what you think.
Oh God, I'm just glad I'm strapped in so tightly. And we're on cold tires now, we can say that, if it gets yes. A little bit lively.
Yeah.
All the traction control is off?
Yeah.
Right.
We want it lively, do we?
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. You want to show off, then you'd be my guest. Right then, let's see what this Turbo GT can do. Oh my goodness me. Well, it feels airborne there, over the crest into turn one. Nailed to the apex there. How's the brake feel?
Perfect.
Oh, you would say that, you've been paid by Porsche. This is not driving, this is teleportation. Bit of front end push there, then the drift on the way out. Yeah, definitely tell there's more power going to the rear than in the standard turbo. Just the traction out of the core is biting. lunch just once today. I don't need to see it again. I can't even describe what he's doing here. You know, the reaction times that you would need for this are monumental. Right, corkscrew. Big sideways.
Apologies for my lackluster commentary, which hardly did Martin Brundle proud. I couldn't decide between watching Lars's lightning-fast, mesmerising reflexes or just looking out the window and trying to concentrate on the view outside. It's a very, very eerie experience being in a machine that's going this fast but making almost no noise.
Final corner, just feel the overboost coming out of here. Big sideways again. Woohoo! That was a 1:29, so even that with a passenger on board is a sub 90 second lap. You're absolutely crazy. I don't know who needed a faster car than a Taycan Turbo, but you're going to need a very, very strong stomach to deal with the sort of thing that this thing can pull off. There we go. Survived Laguna Seca, didn't get Laguna Sica. Appreciate it. Right, where's the toilet?